Very good morning to everyone. We are going to discuss the third chapter, synthetic fibers and plastics from 8th class physics. Children, in previous classes we discussed about how the plastic is dangerous to our atmosphere and how we are facing problems regarding to the usage of plastic. Already I told you, don't use plastic. Instead of plastic, use cotton and the jute bags. Then we can save our environment. So this plastic causing lot of diseases, and if we are using this plastic, it increase the air pollution. Otherwise, if we are born in the plastic, it causes air pollution. It releasing harmful gases into our atmosphere. Okay, these gases are highly reactive metals. Then it facing acid rains, and it collapse so many buildings and apartments. Okay, the pH level which is increasing, acidity increasing, and we are facing some respiratory problems, chronic disorders like asthma, cancer, etc. So suddenly we are not taking the decision to stop entire usage of plastic. Okay, so the plastic is a useful material in our day-to-day life. So that's why we must use plastic. But plastic causes different types of diseases to our day-to-day life. Okay, so what happens nowadays? So many people are using plastic. The usage of plastic leads to dangerous diseases, and it will spoil our atmosphere or environment. Okay, so that's why we must prevent the usage of plastic. Okay, so by taking some steps we can avoid the usage of plastic. Now I'm going to discuss about the topic. Okay, how to avoid plastic usage by using 4R principle. Okay, very important, 4 marks question also. That is 4R principle. Children, nowadays we are using mostly plastic. Okay, but we cannot stop the total usage of plastic, but we can control the usage of plastic to follow 4R rules. Okay, what are the 4R principle? First one, reuse. Second one, reduce. Third one, recover. Fourth one, recycle. Fourth one, recycle. Okay, what are the 4R principle to control the usage of plastic? First one, reuse. Again and again. Re means what? Again and again. Again and again using. Okay, reduce. Reduce means decrease. The usage of decrease. Okay, next to recover. We have to collect the old plastics and recycle. We have to recycle again the old plastics. Okay, now we are going to discuss one by one how we reuse, how we reduce, how we recover, and how we recycle the plastic waste materials. Okay, first I am going to discuss about reuse. Okay, children, generally I am saying this topic. Okay, for example, we are going to market and empty hand we are going to market. By coming from the market, we are bringing lot of plastic covers with vegetables. Okay, so we are using vegetables at our home, but we are throwing the plastic covers into our atmosphere or in the dustbin. So that is not a waste of plastic. Okay, so after coming from market to home, then you collect the vegetables and you keep in the refrigerator. Then you wash the plastic covers. The next time when you are going to market, you carry that plastic covers along with you. Okay, if we are following this process, we can reduce. Okay, we can reuse the plastic materials again and again. Okay, simply we are drinking water in the water bottles and we are throwing outside. So the bottles are useful to you, because you are going to market to bringing milk, oil, and some water and some liquid juices like that. So whenever you are going once it was used. Okay, so reuse the plastic materials whenever it is damaged completely. Okay, whenever it is damaged completely. Okay, children, reuse the plastic materials again and again till they damage. Okay, then we can control the usage of plastic. Okay, next one, reduce. Children, for example, we are going to functions and we are eating meals in the plastic papers and we are drinking water in the plastic glasses. Okay, after completion of eating and drinking process, we are throwing outside the plastic papers and plastic covers. So it pollute our land and it causes a lot of problems to our environment. Okay, so instead of plastic plates and plastic glasses, you use steel plates and steel glasses. Then we can reduce the usage of plastic, you know. Yes, once you think about that. So we are doing so many functions. Okay, so in that functions we are using all plastic glasses and plastic plates. Okay, so it causes a lot of air pollution and it spoil our earth and it does not allow the rain water into the underground. So that's why instead of plastic you use steel, instead of plastic you use steel. So then if you are using steel plates and steel glasses, we can reduce the usage of plastic. Okay, so children, you are you take a step towards the prevention of plastic. Okay, you inform to your parents, neighbors and relatives. They will listen your words. Okay, then reduce the usage of plastic. Next, to recover. Children, this mostly we are doing badly. Okay, so once we are using plastic materials, we are throwing into the drainages and we are throwing into the outside and whatever it may be. So what happens? Okay, so if we are throwing like that, means it is going to drainages and it is clogging the water in the drainages. Otherwise, it is going to reach in the ponds, lakes, rivers. It will spoil the water. It destroy the aquatic organisms. Okay, if we are burning, it causes air pollution like that. So once you use plastic materials, you don't throw outside. Okay, some people are coming to buy the plastic materials. Okay, what purpose they are buying the plastic waste materials? They are collecting all the waste plastic materials from our surroundings and from at home. Okay, and they are preparing new plastic from the old plastics. Okay, they are preparing new plastic items from the old plastic items. So like that, they will recover the old plastic. Okay, next one, recycling. Children, we know already our paper is also recycled paper. Okay, so the white color paper which is in long notebook, that is fresh paper which is obtained from plants. Okay, so but we are writing rough notes, you know, that somewhat brownish color paper. Okay, that is very thin paper, that is nothing but recycled paper. Okay, the recycled paper we are getting from old papers. Children, now what you are doing, you are writing some mistakes and you are writing some whatever it may be. Okay, and you are throwing, you are tearing the paper and you are throwing outside. Okay, so but by the preparation of paper, we need trees. Okay, how paper is made up of, do you know? The people are cutting trees and they are making the papers. So if you are throwing unnecessarily papers outside, indirectly you are killing a plant. Okay, if you are throwing unnecessarily a paper outside, indirectly you are killing a plant. So children, that's why please don't throw papers unnecessarily. Okay, if one time, okay, for example, you are writing one side of the paper. Okay, so this one side of the paper is completed, then you are throwing paper. Don't do like that. On the next side you have empty space, you know, you practice diagrams or max problems in that empty paper, then you can save the paper. Okay, so that's why please children, don't throw papers unnecessarily. If you are throwing papers, indirectly you are killing plants. Okay, you are spoiling our atmosphere. That's why don't throw the paper. Children, like paper, plastic also recycled again. Okay, we are using some water bottles. In that numbers are there. Already paint mass I explained to you. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like that numbers are there. It is 9.
touch the children. Once you see bottom of the water bottle, okay, it is made up of some number. Okay, if number is present, that is what are recycled plastic. Okay, does not cause any harm to us. Okay, recycled plastic does not cause any harm to us. Okay, you have to use. Okay, no problem about that. You have to use if we are following some rules. We can save the usage of plastic. Okay, so by using what type of rules we are saving the plastic? Reuse means we have to use, reuse and use again the plastic items. Then we can save the plastic. Next, reduce. Okay, so reduce the usage of plastic items. Next, to recover. Okay, don't throw the plastic materials outside unnecessarily. You have to collect the plastic waste materials. Okay, and you have to sell to the people, those who are coming to buy the plastic. Next, you have to if you are storing the plastic waste materials, if you are selling to a person, the person is doing what? The person is collecting all the waste plastic materials. From that he is making new plastic materials. Okay, new plastic materials. Like this we can save our plastic. Okay, we can save the usage of plastic and we can save our environment. Okay, so paper is also coming from plants. Don't waste the paper. Okay, save the paper. Understand? Save the paper. So this is about what Nana 4R principle. Okay, you can give any examples also as your own decision. Okay, next, the government has suggested prevent the usage of plastic. Okay, one symbol is given. Okay, what is the symbol? The recycling symbol. Okay, this is the universal recycling symbol. Okay, three arrows indicates what Nana? Reduce, reuse, recover. Okay, this is called universal recycling symbol. Okay, now this is the universal recycling symbol. I am writing on the board. Okay, three arrows. Okay, this is what? Universal recycling symbol. Universal recycling symbol indicates what? Reduce, reuse, recover. Okay, na? Means we must reduce the usage of plastic, we must reuse the plastic, and we must recover the plastic. Okay, so then we can save at least our earth from plastic. Okay, if you will not stop usage of plastic, please follow these steps and we can save our environment. Okay, next topic, what is the role of ports in recycling process? Children, already Prem Kumar sir explained to you. Okay, some ports are available on the plastic materials like PET, okay, PVC and PT, HDTC, like that. Okay, now Prem Kumar sir explained to you. So the ports indicates what? That is nothing but recycling plastic. Okay, that is nothing but what, Nana? Recycling plastic. Okay, uncoated plastic. Children, some plastic items do not contain codes. Okay, for example, what? Toys, computer key. So children, we must ban usage of plastic. Instead of plastic, we use cotton and jute bags. Whenever you are going to market and when you are going to shopping complex. Okay, so if you will follow these rules and regulations, we can save our earth from usage of plastic. Okay, we can save the earth from usage of plastic. So nowadays, so many industries and companies are making plastic for the commercial purpose, but the usage of plastic will give so many disadvantages on our plants, animals and human beings. Okay, nowadays we are facing so many problems due to the usage of plastic. So now we are educated, you know, that's why we must ban the usage of plastic. Okay, in instead of plastic, so many items are there. I already told you in the functional season, so you must use steel plates and glasses instead of plastic. Okay, and in the hotels also, the people are using cups in the cups for pouring tea. Okay, instead of plastic cups, we have to use paper cups. Okay, it will not harm to our environment. So that's why from this topic, what you understand, Anna? The plastic is a very hazardous material which is dangerous than atom bomb. Okay, which is dangerous than atom bomb. Okay, next, Supreme Court of India suggested that, okay, in the government of India, Supreme Court of India suggested in the 2003 year, Supreme Court of India banned the usage of plastic covers. Okay, banned the usage of plastic covers, and the government has collected so much plastic from the garbage of municipalities and major cities. Okay, major cities. Why? Because people are using plastic and they are throwing outside into our atmosphere. Okay, this plastic create a lot of solid waste on our environment, on our earth. Okay, this plastic create a lot of solid waste management on the earth. Okay, so many animals and birds are eating that plastic covers, and they are dying due to the because of eating plastic. Okay, so but we must save plastic. Okay, we must protect, we must prevent the usage of plastic. How, Nana? So if the government should take action, okay, it is not a single person duty. So the government also must take an action. Okay, one solution is there. If we collect the total solid waste materials, from that we can separate biological waste and non-biological waste. Biological waste we can use like a manure in the agricultural field. Okay, and non-biological waste materials like electricity waste materials, plastic waste materials, we are using in the preparation of thermal electricity. Okay, we are using in the preparation of thermal electricity and in the preparation of fuel. Okay, so if we are keeping effort on this topic, then we can save our earth from plastic free world. Okay, children, so from this topic, what you understand? The usage of plastic, we cannot ban completely, but we can solve this problem by following four R principle, that is reuse the plastic materials again and again, reduce the usage of plastic materials, and recover the waste plastic materials, then recycle that waste plastic materials into new plastic materials. Okay, then it is called universal recycling symbol. Okay, which indicates what? Reuse, reduce, and recover plastic items. Okay, Supreme Court of India also banned the usage of plastic in the year 2003, but still people are using plastic. Okay, still people are using plastic. Then who are getting problem? We are only getting problem by usage of plastic. Okay, it leads to air pollution, it leads to kill the aquatic plants and animals, it causes different types of dangerous diseases on the earth, it is spoiling our environment. Okay, we are not getting time to time rains, we are not getting sufficient amount of rains in the rainy season because of plastic. It leads to acid rain and it leads to thunderstorms, tsunami, tufan, etc. Okay, so children, please avoid the usage of plastic. Okay, for every problem there is a solution. Then don't use plastic. Instead of plastic, use jute and cotton bags. Okay, then we can save our environment, then we can save our earth from plastic free society. Okay, hope you understand this video. Homework. Read about 4R principle. This is your homework. Hope you understand this video. Don't skip the video in between. Watch full video, then you can understand the subject. Okay? Thank you.
A very good morning, children. We are going to discuss the fourth chapter, reproduction in animals, from 8th class biology. Children, in before classes, we already discussed about what is called a reproduction and what are the types of the reproduction process. Children, what is called a reproduction? Re means again and again. Production means giving birth to young ones. Okay, so the organisms are giving birth to their young ones again and again to increase the population and to continue the species from one generation to another generation. This process is called reproduction. Okay, this process is very essential, Nana. If we stop reproduction process, there is no next generation. Okay, so if we continue our reproduction process, what happened? The future generation will be present. Okay, so reproduction is very important process to continuation of the species in the environment, and this reproduction process is mainly classified into two types. The first one is asexual reproduction and the second one is sexual reproduction. Already we discussed in the previous classes what is called asexual reproduction. If the reproduction process is takes place without formation of zygote, is called asexual reproduction. Mainly unicellular organisms and some plants carry asexual reproduction process. Okay, in the previous class we discussed about the second type, sexual reproduction. What is called sexual reproduction? The male and female organisms combine together to form a zygote. This type of reproduction is called sexual reproduction. Children, in previous classes we discussed about how the sexual reproduction takes place in the case of Datura plant, and how the sexual reproduction which is takes place in the animals and human beings. Okay, so what is the male reproductive organ? Testis. It produces sperms. What is the female reproductive organ? Ovaries, to produce ova or egg. Okay, so what happens here? The male reproductive part is testis and the female. The second one is what, Nana? Female. Okay, what is the reproductive part in the female? Ovary. Okay, so what happens here? The male reproductive part, testis, produce sperm cells, and the female reproductive part, ovary, produce ovule or egg. So what happens here? The sperm cells are fusion with egg. Okay, children, yesterday we discussed about the structure of sperm cell. Sperm cell contain nucleus. Sperm cell contain nucleus, and the female ovule also contain nucleus. Female ovule also contain nucleus. Here what happens, Nana? The nucleus of the sperm cell which fusion with female nucleus. Okay, so male nucleus fusion with female nucleus to form a single nucleus. Okay, to form a single nucleus. Okay, this nucleus develops into zygote, and the zygote develops into embryo. Embryos develop into fetus. Okay, and the fetus develop into new baby. Okay, so this is about what, Nana? Sexual reproduction, which is takes place in the human beings. Okay, children, what happens here? The sperm nucleus combines with egg. The sperm nucleus combines with egg to form a zygote. zygote. Okay, this process is called fertilization. Very important, one more question children. Fertilization. Okay Nana, what is called fertilization? The male reproductive organ, testes, produce sperm cells. Female reproductive organ, ovary, produce egg. So both contain nucleus. Okay, both contain nucleus. The nucleus of the sperm cell which fusion with the nucleus of the egg cell. Okay, so two form a zygote. This type of fertilization is called sexual fertilization, and this process is called fertilization. Okay, fertilization process which is takes place in the human beings, it leads to development of new baby. Okay children, now today's our topic is fertilization. Today our topic is what Nana? Fertilization. Children, what is called fertilization Nana? Fusion of sperm cell with ova leads to development of new baby. This process is called fertilization. Okay, so this fertilization process, these are mainly two types. First one, internal fertilization. Okay, what is that Nana? Internal fertilization. Okay, the second process is called external fertilization. Okay, the second process is called external fertilization. Okay children, what is fertilization Nana? Sperm cell fusion with egg cell to form a single nucleus. Okay, this nucleus develops into zygote and a new baby. Okay, so the process is called fertilization, which is belongs to sexual reproduction in the case of human beings. Okay Nana, so this fertilization is around mainly two types. The first one is internal fertilization, the second one is the external fertilization. Children, what is the meaning of internal? Internal means inside. Okay, inside of the body. What is the meaning of external Nana? Outside of the body. Okay, outside of the body. Children, what is the example of internal fertilization? For example, human beings. Okay, for example, what Nana? Human beings. Okay, next, insects, lizards, snakes, mammals. Okay children, so fertilization is around two types, internal fertilization and external fertilization. If the fertilization process takes place inside of the female body, children, if the fertilization process takes place inside of the female body, that is called internal fertilization. For example of internal fertilization, organisms like human beings, insects, lizards, snakes, mammals. What are called mammals Nana? Which animals giving milk to their babies? For example, camel, goat, sheep, buffalo. Okay, and female like that. So these are called what Nana? Mammals. Okay, so these are the example of internal fertilization. Then second one, what is called external fertilization? If the fertilization process takes place outside of the female body, if the fertilization process takes place outside of the female body, that is called external fertilization. Okay, example what Nana? Frogs. Okay, example what? Frogs. Okay, frogs carry external fertilization. Okay, now we are going to discuss the first type is internal fertilization. Okay, first we are discussing about what Nana? Internal fertilization. Okay children, what is called internal fertilization? If the fertilization process is
reproductive part of the male is testes, female is ovary. So the both reproductive parts of the male and female, which is located inside of the body, okay, which is located inside of the body. Children, the male reproductive organ testes, which is present outside of the male body, okay, and the female reproductive organ ovary, which is located inside of the female body. Here what happens, Nana? The testes release the number of sperms, okay, testes release number of sperms into the female ova, okay. So the ova contain egg, then what happens here, the sperm nucleus combines with ovum nucleus. Here is a fusion of gametes, is takes place, it leads to fertilization process, okay, na? So here what do you understood, Nana? The female reproductive organ testes, which is present outside of the male body, okay, sorry, the male reproductive organ, which is present outside of the male body, that is testes, okay. Next, female reproductive organ ovary, which is present inside of the female body, then what happened, the testes release number of sperms into the female ovary, there fusion of gametes are takes place, it leads to fertilization, okay, now. So here what happened, female reproductive organ, which is located inside of the body, okay, and it receives the sperms from male, and it leads to fusion of gametes, okay, these gametes are responsible for fertilization process, okay, gametes are responsible for fertilization process. In the fertilization process, what happens, Nana? So first the matured egg, okay, first the matured egg, when it is combined with sperms, children please understand, Nana, when the sperm cells are going to react with matured egg, here what happens, Nana, fertilization process takes place, then it leads to development of tissue, okay, it leads to development of tissue, okay. So what is called tissue, Nana? A group of cells, children, already I told you a group of cells are present in the tissue, okay. When the sperm cell fusion with egg, it leads to development of tissue, okay, tissue contain group of cells, okay. Then after few days the tissue develops into organ, okay. So this organ is developed into embryo. This organ is developed into embryo. Embryo develops into fetus. Embryo develops into fetus. Fetus develops into new baby. Okay, Nana? Fetus develops into new baby. Like this, what happens? embryo which attached, the embryo which is attached to the uterus of the female. Okay, so this embryo, see Nana, uterus release jelly like substance. Due to that, the uterus has a capability to attract the embryo towards itself. So that's why the embryo which is attached to the female uterus. Okay, so when the embryo is growing, it is converted into fetus. Okay, it is converted into fetus, and fetus develops and it is converted into new baby. Okay, it is converted into new baby. Then what happens now? The stage between the, okay, the time gap between the formation of embryo into fetus. Okay, formation of embryo into fetus. Okay, so it is called a formation of embryo into fetus. Okay, it is called fertilization period. Okay, then the fetus develops into new baby. The fetus develops into new baby. Okay, then what happened Nana? From embryos to new baby. Okay, formation of embryo, it develops into new baby. Between the fetus to new baby,
okay, and embryo which is attached to uterus of the female body, and the embryo which is developed into fetus. The time gap between the embryo and fetus is called pregnancy period. Fetus developed into new baby. The time gap between the fetus and the new baby is called gestation period. Okay, what is the overall pregnancy period? 9 months. Otherwise, it is about 270 to 290 days. Okay, now after 290 days or after 9 months, the new baby will come outside into our world. Okay, so the type of fertilization is called internal fertilization. Okay, the second one is external fertilization. Okay, what is the second type of fertilization? External fertilization. Children, what is called external fertilization? If the fertilization process takes place outside of the female organism. If the fertilization process takes place outside of the female, body, means in this type of fertilization, the female contain reproductive parts outside. That's why outside only fertilization processes takes place. So this type of fertilization is called as external fertilization. Here also fusion of gametes takes place, zygote formation takes place, it leads to development of new baby. Okay, for example of external fertilization, frogs. Okay, for example of external fertilization, frogs. Okay, in later class we'll discuss about the life cycle of the frog. Okay children, so what is the second one, Nana? External fertilization. Here what happens? The female organism contains reproductive part outside of the body. That's why the reproduction process takes place outside of the female body. That's why it is called external fertilization. Okay, now for example, frogs. Okay, this is about today's class. What we discussed, Nana, today? What is called fertilization and what are the types of fertilization? Okay, what is called fertilization? Sperm fusion with egg cell. Okay, to form a single nucleus is called fertilization. These are two types. First one, internal fertilization, which is takes place inside of the female body. Example, human beings. Second one is the external fertilization, which is takes place outside of the female body. Example, frogs. Okay, in the next class we will discuss about the life cycle of the frog. Okay children, understand? Next one. Children, today's homework, first question, read about fertilization process. Read about fertilization process. The second one, explain the types of fertilization. Okay, explain the types of fertilization. Explain the types of fertilization. In that first one, what now? Internal fertilization. And the second one is external fertilization. Okay children, what is your homework? Read about fertilization process and read about the types of fertilization process, that is internal and external fertilization. Okay children, in later classes we will discuss about test tube baby concept and life cycle of the frog. Okay.